In the first video on Debugger Upskill, I talked about the basic and advanced stepping techniques. And in this video, I'll cover how you can access the state of your code by using variables, evaluate expression, and watches. But what do you mean by the state of your code? It could mean a lot of things, and the answer depends on whom you are asking this question to. For this video, it refers to the state of your variables, their values, which are accessible at any point in time. To get a better hang of the debugger features that I just mentioned, let's walk through the functionality of the demo code that I'll debug in this video. This is part of a project that I'm creating for design students. This screen shows beautiful color cards and palettes with four colors each. And design students use these predefined color cards or palettes to select a color scheme for their projects. A lot of time when the students are browsing through these cards, they like a particular color in a palette. For example, a student might like this color and they try to find another card which has this color but with a different combination. So they could do that by right-clicking and finding cards with similar shade. So this works well. Let's try another color and find cards which has a similar shade like this shade of green. This looks good too. But when I was trying to work with this code, I found that I don't get the expected results for all of these colors. For an example, when I click on this shade here and I try to find cards with similar shades, this is what I get. In this color card, there is no matching shade for this particular color. And this is what we'll debug in this video. This is the class that will start my main application. But I know that when I right click on a color and ask it to show me the other palettes which have a similar shade, find similar method in color panel will execute. I'll set a breakpoint here, go back to my main class and start that in the debug mode. Once the execution starts, I can right click and select find cards with similar shade. And this is when the execution will stop on my breakpoint. So the first line of code in this method retrieves the background color of the panel that we just right clicked on. And let me go to the next line of code using step over or F8. And before I talk about the rest of the code, let me mention that now we're going to use the variables to determine the state of this application. The variable values are displayed in line in the editor pane and they can also be viewed in the debug tool window here in this panel. One of the main benefits of displaying the variable values in line in the editor pane is that you remain in the flow when you debug your code. For example, to find out what is the value of the variable color, you can view the value here right in the editor pane. You don't have to go to the debug tool window to scroll through all the available variables. By default, these values are on, but if you want to disable them, you can go to find action and search for show values in line and enable or disable them. I'll leave them enabled here for this video. There are much more options if you access the same variable in the debug tool window. For an example, if I access the variable color in the debug tool window, I could right click this and I could inspect it, or I could jump to the type source and do a lot of other things. Let's move forward with debugging our code. On this line of code, I see a call to the get similar palettes method, which is defined in my color utils class. And this seems to return a palette or which are similar to the color that we right clicked on. And the values that it returns are of type palette for colors. Let's see what this class is. I can jump to the source code of this class by navigating to it to go to declaration. And here I see that this is a record with the component's name and four other colors. A lot of time when you are debugging your code, you might jump from one code block to another. To go back to your execution point, you can click in the debug menu on these dots here and click on show execution point. That will take you to the code where our execution point was. Now let's step into the get similar palettes method and see the code in this method. The method starts by creating similar colors, which is an empty array list, and then it iterates over the list of 40 colors that was passed to it. The next line of code in this method calls a similar color method, passing it the first color from the palette, which is in the for loop, and comparing it with the reference color, the color that we right clicked on. So you can see the color in the editor pane. This is the color. And this is the palette, four colors in the palette. And the tolerance is 35, which is the difference in the shade that we want to the range of colors that we are willing to accept as a similar color. Now, let me go to the code of this method, which is step into. A similar color method accepts two instances of type color one. The name of the method parameters are color one and color two, and a tolerance value to determine how much difference would be acceptable to determine whether the two colors are similar or not. Then it creates three local variables, and it uses the get methods to retrieve the red, green, and blue component for the colors, and it calculates the difference between all these components for color 1 and color 2. And at the end, it calculates whether the sum of all three values is less than or equal to tolerance. And the value, the type of the value that it returns is of color difference, which is another record. And it has color 1 and color 2 as components. It states whether the colors are similar and then the tolerance. Now I could go back to my method and execute the code using F8. Now at this point, I would like to talk about the evaluate expression. Sometimes you might want to figure out more than just the value of a variable, like the value of an expression. For example, in similar color method, you might want to figure out what is the value of expression color2.getBlue. You can do that easily by using quick evaluate expression in your editor pane. If I click it here, I see the value 174. Similarly, I can hold down the Alt key and move my cursor along to figure out the value of the expressions that I want. I can also select the expressions and get the value. Now again, I can use the same technique to find out the value of this whole expression. I could also evaluate expression in the editor tool window by going to this pane and you typing the expression value that I want to evaluate in this line of code. I can write color2.getBlue, hit enter and get the value here. How would I choose whether I want to use my editor pane or the debug tool window? If I already have an expression written out in my code, I would prefer to see that in my editor tool window. But if there's an expression that I haven't written in my code, then I would go to the editor tool window. Now let me resume with debugging my code. Let me move to the next line of code. And now I can see that the difference for all the components of the colors, red, green, and blue, is more than the tolerance that I specified initially, which was 35. And this is bound to return a false value. And I want to step out of this method and let's see what I get for the remaining colors. Let's execute all these lines of code which compare the individual colors in the palette of four colors with our reference color. And when I reach this line of code, I've already evaluated all the full colors. I can click here and check if the colors are same or not. This is not same. And of course, a similar is false here. A similar is false in this value too. The similar is false here. The tolerance, I think this should be the difference, not the tolerance. So that's another bug which I need to kind of check later on. So moving to the next line of code, I see that the value of this variable is false, which means that this particular palette instance will not be added to our return value from this method, which is supposed to store similar palettes for our reference color. And the next step is to iterate through all the other values. This is going to take a lot of time. What if I could watch a variable? And this is exactly what I can do with the watches. I can click on this variable and add to watches. I also have an option add inline watch that would add this variable as a watch here in my editor pane. For this example, I'm using the option of add to watches. You can view this variable all the time in the watches panel in the debug tool window. If this variable is out of scope or the frame that you are executing at a particular point of time doesn't have this variable in scope, you would see an error message which says cannot find the local variable. And when you execute the frame that has this variable in scope, then you will be able to view the value of this variable. So let's move forward with executing our code. And now you can see that you see the value true here. Now this is the point where you would like to deep dive into what's happening with the exact palette card that has been selected. Now here I can watch the palette. Now I see that the colors in this palette are similar to my reference color. So I think it's okay. And then I want to move to the other values. And I just saw false. So I'm quickly going through the variable values. And now I see the true value here. And now I want to pause and I want to view the value for the palette here. And now I see the second option, which was displayed in my original code. And I think none of these colors is similar to my reference color. So what went wrong? I can go back to the methods here and click on the color difference. Here the tolerance or the difference technically is 300. Similar is false. Here the tolerance is 174, similar is false. So here the tolerance value is -5, which is not correct because ideally I should be returning the difference of the red, green and blue values, and I was supposed to return the absolute value, which means that it should not be a negative value. So let me go to the code of this method. Now, let me just move this code to separate lines. So first of all, this line of code should not subtract tolerance and just return the sum of the red, green and blue difference between these two colors. Let's compile the code again and debug. So which means stop and rerun. And I'll quickly go through all the steps and reach at the step where we stopped. Now we're back in the same position, and you'll see that when we rerun a debug session, our watches are still there. So that's another benefit of using a watch. And now the value of this variable is true, and I want to go back to my this variable and check the values that I have here. So the tolerance here is 30 and not -5, which is right. And now it also says that it is true. Even though I think these colors are not similar, if I compare the red, green and blue component, which is what I used in my formula, these colors are similar. So either I have to change the tolerance or I have to use another way to find whether a color is similar to the other color. So in short, what I was expecting in my code, that is correct according to the formulas. As the final step, let's change the tolerance value, which checks how similar the colors are, from 35, let's say to 15, and rerun our code. Let me debug this class again with a different value for the tolerance variable, let's say 25 instead of 35. I'm starting the debug session, and once I see the panel of colors, let me again click on find cards with similar shade. I'm already in the find similar method. I want to get to the next line of code and step into this code. And now here I see the tolerance variable, and I can change the value of the tolerance method parameter in the debug tool window without changing the value in my code. I can right click, use set value, and change this value to 25. Once I'm done, I step out of all the methods, and this is how I see the result of execution of this code with the value tolerance value 25, not 35. This looks good to me. Now what I want to do is I want to close the debug session. I want to go to my class color panel in the find similar method. I want to change this to 25, and let's rerun this class using the modified tolerance value and see if we get the right cards here. Find similar cards with the shade. This works good. Now let me click and find cards which are similar to this shade. This looks good as well. These look similar to me. Let me find the one with the brown color. This looks good too. So I think this was a good session, and we managed to debug our code, fix one of the values that I was returning in the getSimilar method code. And in the other method, I managed to change the value for the method parameter tolerance so that I could get the result that I expected. In this video, I covered how you can view the state of your code in the debug mode by using variables, evaluate expressions, and watches. To get a better hang of all these debugger features, I used a demo application and debugged my code using all these features. I hope you liked the video and were able to learn something from it. If yes, do let me know in the comments, and stay tuned for the other videos that we have in the series. Thanks for watching.